Good afternoon, scholars, and welcome to the last Achieve article for the first semester. I am Maria.
And I am Fatima. Today's article is called The Last Generation, and it may be hard to infer what the article may be about just based on this picture.
That makes me curious, Fatima. Before we get into the article, let's do a quick shout out to the three high score classes for the first semester.
In third place is Ms. Garcia's homeroom.
In second place is Ms. Gutierrez's homeroom.
And in first place is Ms. Sandoval's homeroom. Congratulations to these three homerooms for all their hard work this semester.
So today's article takes us to the Pacific Islands location between the United States, Australia, and Asia.
Many of these islands, like the Marshall Islands, are very popular if you like to relax.
Unfortunately, many of these islands are at risk of disappearing due to climate change. As the popular polar ice caps melt, ocean level rise. Last month in Italy, the ocean rose so high they flooded the city of Venice.
The same thing is happening in places like Marshall Islands. Only the Enter Islands is likely to go underwater unless something is done to stop sea level rise.
Rather than be victims and just give up, the people of Major are doing something about climate change. Since most everything comes to Major by cargo ship, they are trying to come up with ways to eliminate diesel smoke.
For example, they are demanding that many of these cargo ships switch to LNG, which produce much less CO2 than diesel.
And remember, keep working on the cheap over vacation. You can continue to improve your lifestyle. Happy holiday, everyone.
Now you see it, now you don't. Over the past year, three small islands across the globe have appeared to simply vanish. First, in the summer of 2018, Russian scientists reported that a small Russian Arctic island disappeared, with only stretches of open water visible at the site, confirming their fears in 2017 when they failed to see the island in satellite photos. Next, in October, Hurricane Welaka washed away the remote 11-acre Hawaiian island called East Island, a critical habitat for some endangered species. A few weeks later, a Japanese newspaper reported that an uninhabited islet off Hokkaido could no longer be found, and it had been used as a part of a chain of islands that delineates Japan's territorial waters. Each of the three islands seem to have slipped below the sea level and off the map. These recent examples are islands that were small and uninhabited, but scientists say they could highlight what's to come on larger landmasses. Kurt Storlazzi, a geologist at the U.S. Geological Survey's Pacific Coastal and Marine Science Center, told Mach, "With some of these small islands, maybe it's no big deal to the average person because they're uninhabited. But you're going to see these same processes happening on larger islands and populated ones." Experts say those processes are happening for a few reasons. Climate change is not increasing the frequency of major storms like the Category 5 hurricane that washed away Hawaii's East Island, but it does seem to be making storms more intense over time. Meanwhile, sea levels are rising, and they don't need to sink entire islands to have a devastating effect. Major flooding could decimate agriculture and communities, as well as reduce the availability of fresh, drinkable water. The recently disappeared islands may not be lost forever. Satellite photos taken last month show parts of East Island appear to be reforming. Seals are even returning to its beaches. But experts say East Island and others may not return to their original size. And whether or not these islands do come back, their recent disappearing acts show just how much our world might change.
Hey, NBC News viewers, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.